Hello, welcome to the Wednesday, April 29th, 2020 edition of the Sands and Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Today's diary is from Jan, and he is looking at some of the history of a recent ancient Tesla mail spam campaigns. And what he sort of sadly noticed is they haven't really changed all that much over the last year. You probably have seen these emails too, the sort of TNT shipping notification messages that then, of course, have a suspect attachment. Kind of always the sad thing that keeps repeating here is that it's not necessarily the new and shiny exploits that cause all the damage. It's all that sort of ongoing bombardment with pretty old tricks, old malware that apparently still works. So the attackers, they don't really have to work that hard to actually infect systems. And VMware released a patch for its ESXi product, fixing a stored cross-site scripting vulnerability that VMware assigned a CVSS score of 8.3, so kind of up there and labeled as important. In order to exploit this vulnerability, an attacker would need to have access to a virtual machine running within ESXi, and they would need to be able to change a virtual machine at like, for example, the host name of the virtual machine. With cross-site scripting, it's always a little bit up to the creativity of the attacker, how much they'll do with it. And of course, an attacker that took over a virtual machine would potentially be able to sort of affect the ESXi management console, which is almost kind of like a virtual machine escape vulnerability. And the Microsoft Threat Protection Intelligence team did publish a pretty extensive blog post about how to reduce the risk from ransomware. Ransomware is sadly still in everybody's mind and lately has been targeting a lot of healthcare and other critical services. So Microsoft is in particular addressing some of these recent attacks to give you some hints in how to protect yourself better and how these attackers work. For example, they point out the need to reduce your external exposure with RDP servers. That's something we have been writing about. Also, how to use some of the Microsoft technologies like Microsoft Defender ATP, some of the other security policies like account lockout policy, tamper protection, and the like to harden your systems to make them a more difficult attack for these ransomware campaigns that can be quite devastating to a lot of businesses. So certainly a worthwhile read, in particular if ransomware hasn't really been sort of a big problem for you, because, well, you may just be next. What they're talking about here are a lot of these sort of human-operated ransomware campaigns. So where actually an attacker is penetrating your network manually, so not something where necessarily you just have one user click on an attachment and the ransomware starts running. And Adobe today released updates for three of its products, Magento, Illustrator, and Adobe Bridge. Both Illustrator and Magento have critical vulnerabilities that are being addressed with this update. Historically, Magento has always been sort of something that has been exploited, and the critical vulnerability being patched here is, again, an arbitrary code execution vulnerability. Adobe gave it a priority rating of 2, which means that they don't anticipate exploits to be imminent. But Adobe suggests that you do apply these updates soon, for example, within the next 30 days. Also, important reminder here, Magento 1, if you're still running it, it runs out of support in June. If you're still running Magento 2.2, that actually ran out of support end of last year. So make sure that you have a recent version like Magento 2.3. That's the current version, or 2.3.4p2 is what you should be running. Well, that is it for today. Thanks for listening, and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.